So now let's cover pediatric bradycardia. First, it's important to know that there can be many forms of bradycardia. Remember, pediatric bradycardia is defined as a slower than normal heart rate for a child's age, their activity level, and their current clinical condition. And when a child is presenting with bradycardia and is hypotensive, it's usually a sign that they're experiencing cardiopulmonary compromise and that very possibly they may be in cardiac arrest pretty soon if we don't treat it right away. The two most common types of bradyarrhythmias in children are sinus brady and atrial ventricular, otherwise known as AV blocks. Possible underlying causes of bradycardia include hypoxia, drug interactions, heart defects, metabolic dysfunction, and traumatic injuries. It's important to remember that asymptomatic sinus bradycardia can be normal, especially for athletes, and may not require treatment. However, it's also vital to remember that if the bradycardia, regardless of the underlying reason, is causing the patient to display serious or life-threatening symptoms related to that bradycardia, the patient must be treated quickly so that the symptoms can be corrected. Identifying and treating reversible causes is the most effective treatment for resolving symptomatic bradycardia. Now, because hypoxemia is the most common cause of bradycardia in children, it's vital to provide proper ventilation and oxygenation early. Cardiac and oxygen saturation monitoring, blood pressure, along with common vitals, also need to be obtained early. In addition, the initiation of a patent IV or IO needs to be a high priority. A 12 lead should be done if available, but treatment should not be delayed in order to get that 12 lead. If there's no hypotension or other signs of cardiopulmonary compromise, we could continue with oxygenation, observe the patient, and consider further expert consultation. Now, if bradycardia persists and there are signs of poor perfusion after the treatment with oxygen, our next treatment is to give medications. Epinephrine at 0.01 milligram per kilogram of 1 to 10,000 IV or IO can be repeated every 3 to 5 minutes. And in the cases where it's primary AV block or increased vagal tone, atropine would be our drug of choice, given instead of epinephrine at 0.02 milligrams per kilogram. Now, this dose of atropine can be repeated once for a total of 0.04 milligrams per kilogram. And when a child's heart rate drops below 60 with signs of poor perfusion, such as an altered mental status or other shock symptoms, it's vital that we start chest compressions immediately. Cardiac pacing may be considered if epinephrine or atropine are not effective.